Hello all, welcome to quantitative aptitude classes. In this session I come up with one topic name is compound interest. If you have an idea, in previous session we have seen the concept of simple interest. So now it's time for compound interest. The main difference between the simple interest and compound interest is, in simple interest, for the given whole time principal amount will not change. Since the principal amount will not change, rate of interest, interest also won't be changed. But whereas in compound interest, so principal amount is keep on increasing, that's why interest also will increase. But if interest is compounded yearly, whether it is simple interest or compound interest, for the first year both are same. I repeat this sentence once again. If interest is compounded yearly, then simple interest and compound interest both are same, because for the first year, whether it is simple interest or compound interest, both we are going to find out on the given principal amount only. Okay, that is the main thing. Remember one thing, in simple interest principal amount will not change, that's why for whatever the given time, interest also won't be changed. Whereas in compound interest, principal amount is keep on increasing, that's why interest also will increase. That is the main difference. Apart from this main difference, that one point is, regarding rate of interest, we have seen two points in simple interest. If you observe, those two points are also applicable in compound interest also. That is, point number one is, rate of interest must be in percentage, that is, it must be for every 100 rupees. And secondly, it must be for only 100 rupees. It must be for only 1 year. So point number one is, rate of interest must be for every 100, that is, it must be for 100 rupees. And secondly, it must be for only 1 year. These two points are also useful in compound interest. And the second point in compound interest is, usually in compound interest, interest need not be compounded annually. Okay, I repeat this sentence once again. Usually in compound interest, interest need not be compounded annually. This we'll discuss by taking a small example. For example, a person borrowed rupees 5000. Okay, at let's say 20% per annum, at 20% per annum rate of interest for 2 years on compound interest, if interest is being compounded half yearly. Okay, so observe the given points here. How much a person borrowed? 5000 rupees. At what rate of compound interest? 20% compound interest. For how many years? 2 years. Whether is it interest compounded annually? No, he mentioned the rate of interest is compounded only half yearly. The important point is, in compound interest, interest need not be compounded annually. If interest is compounded half yearly, rate of interest also should be for the same time, that is, for only half yearly. In compound interest, if interest is compounded quarterly, rate of interest also should be quarterly. In sometimes, in compound interest, rate of interest can be compounded once in every 2 years. At that time, rate of interest also should be for 2 years. Keep this concept in mind. I repeat this point once again. In compound interest, interest need not be compounded annually. If interest is compounded quarterly, rate of interest also should be quarterly. If interest is compounded half yearly, rate of interest also should be for half yearly. If interest is compounded annually, there is no issue. If interest is compounded once in every 2 years, then rate of interest also should be okay for 2 years. This we can keep on, what you can say, going. And secondly, there are two different formulas. First formula is, amount formula, amount A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. In compound interest, amount formula is A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. You know A value, amount, so P value, principal amount, or simply principal, R is equal to rate of interest. Remember, here N is not time. Usually N means, everybody will think that N means time, but remember N means not a time. Here N is nothing but number of periodic payments. Number of periodic payments. What does it mean? For example, interest is compounded quarterly. Interest is compounded quarterly. If interest is compounded quarterly in a year, I have to pay the interest 4 times. If interest is compounded half yearly, right? If interest is compounded half yearly, then rate of interest must be for 2 years, like that. For example, if interest is compounded 2 years, for 4 years again it must be 2 times, like that. So here N means not a time, N means number of periodic payments. For a given stipulated time, how many times he is paying interest? 1 time or 2 times or 3 times or how many times? That you should take it as a N value. Okay, so this is a, and there is no separate formula to find out the interest, to find out the compound interest. If we ask you to find out the compound interest, first of all we need to find out the amount. After getting this amount, from this amount we have to subtract the, what you can say, principal. Then I is equal to A minus P, you get the simply compound interest. So unless until you mentioned compound interest, simply you have to find out the interest. For example, everything will be given, you ask to find out interest. What interest you have to find? Simple interest or compound interest? So if you mention nothing, then think that it is only simple interest. Or if you mention specifically simple interest or compound interest, accordingly we'll find out. Okay, so let's move on to some questions. Okay, so now here it is, the first question regarding compound interest. So what is the question? A money lender lends a sum of rupees 2000 at compound interest of 5%. The amount he receive after 2 years is, he asked to find out amount he receive after 2 years. What he given? P value given. How many rupees? 2000 rupees. Next, rate of interest given. How much given? 5% given. And in this question, if you observe here, he didn't mention whether the compound interest is for quarterly or half yearly or annually. If nothing he mentioned, clearly understand that. So interest is being compounded annually, that is for every 1 year. Okay, so keep this concept in mind. Then A is equals to P value given. How many rupees given? 2000 given. Rate of interest given. Rate of interest, how much given? 5% given. So rate of interest is 5%, means what? So for every 100 rupees, he has to pay the 5 rupees as interest. So simply here I am getting 105 by 100, or simply 105 percentage. 105 percentage can be written as 105 100. Simply this is the amount obtained for 1 year, but he lends the amount for how many years? After 2 years. That's why A is equals to 2000 into 105 by 100 into 105 by 100. So simplification, so for this, right, zeros, for this zeros, 2 zeros plus 1 zero, 3 zeros cancelled. Okay, don't disturb second one. Zeros, 105 into 105. There is a simple calculation, a trick to find out 105 into 105. The trick is, so here clearly 5 fives are, So 5 5 is how much I am getting? 25. Then, so next what is there? Here 10 is there, here also 10 is there. What is the number after 10? So it could be 11. 10 11s are how much? 110. Hence, so 105 into 105 is 11025. But this value we have to multiply with 2. Okay, if I multiply with 2, what I am getting? 05022. Hence, the final answer is 22,050 rupees. 22,050 rupees. So this was the amount, or this is what he asked to find out. So this is the amount he is going to get after 2 years. For example, in the same question, if he asked to find out compound interest, what he will do? Principal amount is 2000, amount is 22,050. Hence interest equal to what you can say, 2050 rupees. I hope you understood. Only remember, I repeat this thing once again. In compound interest, 2 points you need to keep in mind. Point number one is, rate of interest must be in percentage, that is, it must be for every 100 rupees, and it has to be for only 1 year. This is the first thing. And secondly, in compound interest, interest need not be compounded annually. If in the given question, if he mentioned nothing, we are to assume that interest is compounded annually. But sometimes interest may be compounded quarterly, or half yearly, or yearly, or once in every 2 years, whatever, even every month also. So accordingly, you should take the rate of interest. For example, if interest is being compounded quarterly, rate of interest also should be, what you can say, for quarterly, you should say. Okay, so keep this concept, these 2 points in mind. Then we will discuss second point. Here is the second question. So what is the question? Find the compound interest. See, in previous question, he asked to find out amount. But whereas here, he asked to find out the compound interest. Find the compound interest on rupees 5000 at 10% per annum for 2 years, compounded annually. So he only given, how he is doing? So he is compounded annually. Okay, and we'll take the values what he given. So P value is 5000. Okay, simply P value is 5000. That's why 5000. Rate of interest, how much given? 10%. And he asked to find it for how many years? 2 years. Since 10% is rate of interest, for every 100 rupees, 10 rupees interest. What could be my amount? 100 plus 10, 110 percentage. So 110 percentage can be written as 110 by 100 into 110 by 100. This is for first year, and this is for second year. I hope you understood. Now, simplification. If you simplify this, 3 zeros and this 1 zero. For the 4 zeros, these 4 zeros are cancelled, right? 4 zeros are cancelled. So 11 11s are 121. This 121 you have to multiply with 5. So what I am getting? 605. Okay, so 605 and one more zero. What I am getting? 6050. 6050 is the amount. Okay, 6050 is the amount. But what he asked to find? He asked to find out compound interest, not amount. So 60 amount minus principal. What I am getting? 6050 minus 5000. Hence our answer is equal to 1050 rupees. 1050 rupees. I repeat this concept. Amount given, sorry, amount we asked to find interest. If you ask for interest, first of all we have to find out the what you can say, amount. So amount, what I am getting? 6050. So after getting amount, he asked to find out the interest. So my final answer is 1050 50 rupees. I hope you understood. In question number 1, he asked to find out amount. But whereas in question number 2, he asked to find out compound interest. Okay. Here it is the third question. Find the compound interest on rupees 5000 at 12% per annum for 1 year, compounded half yearly. Okay. He asked to find out compound interest. Compound interest, principal amount how much given? 5000 rupees. At what rate of interest? 12% rate of interest. For how much time? 1 year. But interestingly, observe here, he is compounding interest half yearly, not yearly. If it is yearly, rate of interest is 12%. Since interest is compounded half yearly, here we'll take rate of interest as only 6%, not 12%. In that 1 year, how many times he has to pay the interest? 2 times. How? Because time is for 1 year. In 1 year, interest is being compounded half yearly. So first half yearly, and I mean first half for 6 months and for next 6 months. So total 2 times he has to pay the interest. So like that, we have to follow. Principal amount value given 5000 rupees. 5000 into rate of interest. Here you should not take 12%. Here you should not take 12% because I told you 12% is for only yearly, but he asked to find for only half yearly. That's why it must be 106. In that year, he has to pay the interest how many times? 2 times. So 5000 into 106 by 100 into 106 by 100. Okay. So simplification for this 3 zeros, these 2 zeros and 1 zero cancelled. Okay. 106 into 106 into 5 dividing with the, what we can say, 5 ones are 5 twos are 2 ones are 2 fives are 2 threes are. So 106 into 53, 18, right? Here it is 18. 3 six are 18. So 30. Again 3, 5. What I am getting? 8, 1, 6, 5. So what I am getting here? 5,618 rupees. But what he asked to find? He asked to find only compound interest. So we required only compound interest, not the amount. Hence answer is what I am getting? 618 rupees. I hope you understood. Answer is equal to what I am getting? 618 rupees. So this is that main concept in this question is rate of interest given 12%, but you should not take 12%. You should take only 6%. Why? Because interest is being compounded every half yearly. So that's why for yearly 12%, for half yearly 6%. Okay. The same question, for example, if you ask you to find if interest is being compounded quarterly, for 4 quarters 12%, for 1 quarter how much? So okay, so you'll get like that 3% you'll get. Okay. I hope you understood. Keep this concept in mind. Now we'll move to next question. Here it is the fourth question. Okay. Find the compound interest on rupees 16,000 at 20% per annum for 9 months, compound quarterly. Yes, it's a very beautiful question. Observe here, what he asked to find? Firstly, he asked to find out the compound interest. So first we have to find out amount. From that we can able to find out the compound interest. It's clear. Amount how much again? 16,000 rupees. Amount in the sense principal amount. At what rate of interest? 20% rate of interest. So borrowed that amount for how many months? For only 9 months. But is it interest compounded being annually? No. Interest is being compounded only quarterly. In this question, since amount is being compounded quarterly, rate of interest also should be for quarterly. He given yearly rate of interest, that is 12 months rate of interest. So yearly how much he given? 20% given. Okay, so he given yearly rate of interest for 12 months. He given rate of interest is 20, then for 3 months what is the rate of interest? So what I am getting? 3 ones are, 3 fours are, 4 ones are, 4 fives are. So what about my rate of interest? Rate of interest is equal to, I am getting 5%. So this is only quarterly, right? This is only quarterly, not yearly. But he borrowed the amount for how many months? 9 months. In the 9 months, how many times he has to pay the interest? 3 times he has to pay the interest. Okay, that's why amount equal to how much given? 16,000 rupees. 16,000, right, into for first 3 months 105/100, for next 3 months 105/100, for last 3 months again 105/100. So 3 months, total for how many months I'm getting? Total I'm getting for how many months? 9 months. Okay, I hope you understood. So simplification, calculation for the 3 zeros here, 3 zeros cancelled. After simplification, you are getting the amount as how much here? 18,522. It's a clear 18,522. It's a amount. But do we require amount here? No. We required only compound interest. So we required only compound interest. Compound interest equal to from 18,522 subtract 16,000. Okay, so what I am getting? Final answer 2,522. This is the compound interest. This is the answer for the given question. Remember only one point here. Rate of interest given 20%, that is yearly, but interest is being compounded quarterly. That's why we have to find out the rate of interest for quarterly. So yearly 20%, what about quarterly? 5%. So in the 9 months, for how many times he has to pay the interest? 3 times. That's why 16,000 into 105/100 into 105/100 into again 105/100. Simplification. So 18,522 is the amount, but we have to find out the compound interest. So amount minus principal. What is my compound interest? 2,522 rupees. I hope you understood. Now we move on to next question. It is also very interesting question. Observe here. A person borrowed rupees 10,000 at 20% rate of interest for 6 months. Find the interest if interest is being compounded quarterly. In previous question, borrowed for 9 months, interest is being compounded quarterly. That's why 3 times. So here he borrowed the amount for 6 months, but interest is being compounded quarterly. In the 6 months, how many times he has to pay the interest? Clearly 2 times. It's 1 point. And secondly, since interest is being compounded quarterly, rate of interest also should be for quarterly. Yearly rate of interest is 20%. Just now we have seen previous question. What about quarterly rate of interest? 5%. How many times he has to pay? 2 times he has to pay. Okay, first of all we have to find out the amount. Amount A is equals to P value 10,000 for how many months? 6 months. How many times he has to pay the interest? 2 times, because interest is being compounded quarterly. First quarterly, second quarterly. 105/100 into 105/100. So clear this 100 for this 100. 200s, these 4 zeros cancelled. Okay, so simplification. 2 zeros, 2 zeros, 4 zeros cancelled. So simply what I have to do? I have to multiply 105 into 105. Just now I told you a small trick to find out 105 into 105. So 5 5s are what I am getting, 25. Here next, how much there? 10 is there. The number after 10 is how much you'll get? 11. 10 11s are 110. Simply 11,025 rupees. This is the amount, but here I have to find out the compound interest, not amount. Okay, so from 11,025, from 11,025 we can subtract 10,000. That is equal to what I am getting, 1,025 rupees. I hope you understood. This is our final answer. In these two questions, the concept is very clear. Remember, in previous question and in this question, almost same concepts. Interest is being compounded quarterly. That's why rate of interest also should be for only quarterly. If yearly rate of interest is 20%, then quarterly rate of interest is obviously 5%. Means for 12 months, 20, but there for 3 months, how much? So obviously, what I am getting? 5% I am getting. In the 6 months, how many times I have to pay the interest? 2 times I have to pay the interest. So here it is, the total amount is 11,025, but he asked to find out only compound interest. 1,025 rupees is the compound interest. Here it is, the 6th question. What is the question? A sum of money doubles itself at the compound interest in 15 years. In how many years will it become 8 times? I repeat the question once again. A sum of money doubles itself at compound interest in 15 years. In how many years it will be 8 times? Either simply you can use the formula, which is A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N. Or if you think logically, certain sum of money is there. That money doubles itself according to what interest? Compound interest. In how many years? 15 years. Just keep the points. Time is given, how many years? 15 years. And that borrowed amount becomes how much? Doubles itself. Okay. So this will take, and how many times it will be? We required how many times? 8 times. Okay. So from this, we can solve this question very easily. There is a one small logical trick also. By using that trick, we can able to solve this. See, for our simplicity, what I will do is, for example, a person borrowed only rupees 1. Think that person borrowed only 1 rupee. Okay. And this borrowed 1 rupee, borrowed amount will be doubled itself in every 15 years. Borrowed amount will be doubled means, what does it mean? If I borrow 1 rupee, that 1 rupee should become how many rupees? 2 rupees. Okay. Borrowed amount will become 2 times. For our simplicity, I am taking, if I borrow 1 rupee, 1 rupee should become how many rupees? 2 rupees. In how many years? In only 15 years. Okay. So clearly, can I say one point here? What it is? For 15, every 15 years it is doubled. 1 rupee for 2 rupees. Then 2 rupees will become how many rupees? 2 rupees will become 4 rupees. Okay. 2 rupees will become 4 rupees. For how many years? Again 15 rupees. 4 rupees will become how many years? 8 rupees. For how many years? Another 15 years. Are you getting what I am saying? For our simplicity, what I am taking, if a person borrowed 1 rupee, 1 rupee doubles itself in 15 years. What does it mean? If I borrow 1 rupee, 1 rupee becomes 2 rupees. 2 rupees becomes 4 rupees. 4 rupees becomes 8 rupees. So I borrowed only 1 rupee. This 1 rupee becomes how many times? 8 times. So 1 rupee becomes 8 times in how many years? 15, 15, 15. Total how many years? 45 years. I hope you understood what I am saying. Since it is a concept of compound interest, 1 rupee, 2 rupees. 2 rupees, 4 rupees. 4 rupees, 8 rupees. So still if you ask to find 8 rupees, 16. Another 15 years. 16, 32. 32, 64, 128 and so on for every 15 years. I hope you understood. Okay, see here, I need to say one more point here. For example, if it is a question from simple interest, then what you'll do? So here, if it is a concept of simple interest, question is regarding only compound interest. But for example, if you given regarding simple interest, what you'll do? I borrow 1 rupee, 1 rupee become 2 rupees for how many years? 15 years. So for 15 years, interest is 1 rupee. Since it is simple interest, that too principal amount will not change. That's why we know that interest also won't be changed. For every 15 years, you'll get the interest as only 1 rupee. Because for next 15, 1 rupee interest, it will be 3 rupees. So another 15 years, 1 rupee, that's why 4 rupees. So 15, 5 rupees, 6, another 15 years, 7, another 15 years, 8, another 15 years. Okay, because here it is simple interest. So interest will not be changed, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 15 sevens are 105 years. If it is a case of compound interest, how many years are required? 45 years are required. If it is a case of simple interest, how much is required? 105 years required. But remember, question he asked to find for only compound interest. Hence, our answer equal to how many years? 45 years. I hope you understood what I am saying. A certain sum of money amounts to 6050 in 2 years and amounts to 6655 in 3 years. Then find the rate of interest. He asked to find out the rate of interest. A certain sum of money amounts to 6050 rupees in 2 years and amounts to 6655 rupees in 3 years. Then find the rate of interest. So then one small correction here. So the correction is, it's a interest only, but what rate of interest here? Compound rate of interest. Keep in mind. Okay, that is the very important concept. Here it is not there in the given question. Please note everybody. It is not a, of course, you ask to find out interest, but since our topic related to compound interest, then find the rate of interest means we have to find out the compound rate of interest, not simple rate of interest. Okay, so we'll move on to the question. For 2 years, it amounts to how much? For 2 years, it amounts to 6050 rupees. For 2 years, it will be 6050. And for 3 years, right? For 3 years, it will be what you can write? 6655 rupees. According to what rate of interest here? According to compound rate of interest. This is 2 years amount and this is 3 years amount. What is the difference in time? Only 1 year, right? Difference in time is 1 year. So what is the difference in this amount? Clearly, difference in this amount is equal to, I am getting 605 rupees. Okay, see, why I am getting 605 rupees extra for 1 year gap? Because it is obviously interest. Interest for how many years? Interest for only 1 year. But on what rate of, on what sum? Because we know one thing. What we know, usually second year amount is considered as principal for third year. Third year amount is considered as principal for fourth year. Fourth year amount is considered as principal for next year. So it's keep on going. So I am receiving 605 interest on what we can say 650 rupees. That's why. So what he asked to find out, then find the rate of interest. What rate of interest here? Remember, compound rate of interest. Candidate should remember. So here it is only appearing rate of interest. So we have to imagine that it's compound rate of interest. So it should be CI, not SI. So since it is a case of compound interest, how we are going to solve is 6050 rupees. My interest is what I am getting? 605. Then for 100 rupees, what could be my rate of interest? See, why I am taking for 100 rupees? He asked to find out rate of interest. Rate of interest must be for only every 100 rupees for only 1 year. Simplification, 00 cancelled, 605 onesa, 605 onesa. Hence, what is my answer? 10% is the answer. Okay, I hope you understood. So, in this question, the beautiful logic is 2 years amount given, 3 years amount given. So, difference between the amount is 605 rupees. 605 is the interest for how many years? For 1 year. Why I am getting extra? Obviously, it is interest. What interest it is? And remember, it is only compound interest. So, I am getting 605 compound interest on what amount? 6050. Why? Because it is compound interest. So, according to known concept, second year amount is considered as principal amount for third year. So, from that, I am getting the answer is 10%. I hope you understood. So, now we'll move on to next question. A sum amounts to 8,640 in 3 years at 20% per annum compound interest. Find the sum. Wow. A sum amounts to 8,640 in 3 years at 20% per annum compound interest. Find the sum. In previous questions, if he given principal, then we can able to find out the amount or interest. But whereas in this question, he given 3 years amount and he asked you to find out the sum. So nothing he mentioned means we have to assume that interest is being compounded every yearly. What the value is given? Amount is 8,640 rupees. Let principal amount is equal to x. X into rate of interest, how much you given? 20% given. That's why 120 by 100 into again 120 by 100. Okay, for how many times you should take? We should take for 3 years. Again, what I am getting? 120 by 100. If I will do like this, I will get the amount. Total amount how much given? 8,640 rupees. 8,640 rupees. I repeat this once again. In previous question, he asked to give the principal. Okay. He has to give principal. He asked to find out either compound interest or amount. But whereas in this question, amount given, but he asked to find out the, what you can say, principal amount. Let principal amount be x, rate of interest be 20. Since nothing he mentioned, we have to assume that interest is being compounded every annually. That's why 120 by 100 into, for first year 1 year, 120 by 100, second year, 120 by 100, third year. Simplification. This will cancel. 1, 2, 3. For this 3 zeros, zeros are cancelled. Cancelling with 12 table. 12 sevens are 84. 12 twos are 24, 0. Again, 12 6 are 72. Again, 12 5 are 60. So, x equal to 100 into 10, 1000, 1000 into 5. 1000 into 5 is equal to how much I am getting? 5000 rupees. Okay. In previous sessions, if you remember, we have seen the concept of simple interest. Now, compound interest. But hereafter, for these questions, okay, for these questions, there is a concept of both simple interest as well as compound interest. So, before going to say the explanation for this question, there is a one small shortcut formula for this. There is a formula, D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. And again, D is equal to PR square into 300 plus R by 100 into 100 into 100. This is exclusively for 2 years. This is exclusively for 3 years. This is for 2 years. This is for 3 years. What you will do by using this formula? By using this formula, we can able to find out the difference between the simple interest, right? Difference between the simple interest and compound interest for 2 years as well as for 3 years. If you don't know this formula, what you will do? You have to find out the simple interest for 2 years separately, compound interest for 2 years separately, then difference. If it is a case of 3 years, SA separately, CA separately, again difference. It's lengthy procedure, but by using this formula we can able to find out the simple interest and the compound interest for 2 years. Remember, for 2 years formula is what? D is equal to PR square into 100 into 100. For 3 years, what is the formula? PR square into 300 plus R by 100 into 100 into 100. So by using this concept, now we can able to solve the questions. The difference between the SI and CA for 2 years is rupees 15 at 5% rate of interest. Find the sum. Difference given 15 rupees. Rate of interest given 5%. Then you ask her to find out the sum. So for how many years? For 2 years. For 2 years formula is what? Difference D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. 100 into 100. So difference E only given. Difference is 15. P value we have to find. What about R value? R value given 105. 5 means simply we'll take it as R value 5. Substituting all the corresponding values. 5 ones are 5, 3s are 15. So hence we are getting 100 into 100 10,000, 10,000 into 3. What is the principal amount value? 30,000. I hope you understood. This is the formula, exclusive formula for only 2 years. Formula is what? D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. So difference you only given 15. P value we have to find. Rate of interest given 5. And substituting all the corresponding values, I am getting P value. I hope you understood this question. Then we will move on to next question. Find the difference between the SI and CI. In previous question, E given difference between SI and CI. But now he is asking to find out the difference between SI and CI. On the sum, rupees 4000 at 10% rate of interest. R value given, P value given. We have to find out the difference between the SI and the CI. Let's start the solution. Okay. Formula is D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. So now we have to find out D value. To find D value, P value given. P value how much given? 4000 rupees. Right? P value given 4000 rupees. And rate of interest also given. Rate of interest how much given? 10% given. Rate of interest value is 10% by 100 into 100. Taking all corresponding values. Okay. So simplification for this 30 and one this zero. For the four zeros cancelled. What I am getting total amount? Difference is equal to how many rupees I am getting? I am getting it as 4 rupees. Okay. Formula is what? D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. I hope you understood this question. Okay. Directly formula, substituting corresponding values, will get the answer. D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. If it is for 3 years, D is equal to PR square into 300 plus R by 100 into 100 into 100. Okay. So this is the case. Okay. Practice well. Practice all the models well. Then definitely you will get the good command on simple interest and compound interest. Remember, in last few questions, we focused on SI and CI both. last question in this session. On a certain sum of money for 2 years, SI and CA are respectively 40 and 41 rupees. Then find the sum and the rate of interest. There are two different concepts here. He asked to find out. See, observe what he asked to find. Find the sum and he asked to find out the rate of interest. There are two different concepts. Okay, sum is there and rate of interest is there. On a certain sum of money, rate of interest, how much simple interest is 40, compound interest is 41. Then you ask to find out interest and the sum. Now we'll start doing solution. See, observe here what he given. This is something logical question. See, let's say since he mentioned it is a case of 2 years, first year and second year. Okay, and here first year we'll talk about simple interest and we'll talk about second year compound interest. Total simple interest, how much given? 40 rupees. We know first year simple interest is 20 rupees and second year simple interest is also 20 rupees. Total simple interest is 40 rupees. For the first year, there is no difference in simple interest and compound interest. That's why, so my first year compound interest must be, how much I have to get? 20 I have to get. Okay, so if it is 20, this must be how much? 21. 20 plus 21, how much here? 41. So for 2 years simple interest, for 2 years compound interest. Okay, see, for the second year, on this 20 rupees, how much extra I'm getting? 1 rupee extra I'm getting. Okay, that's why. So first case, we can find out the rate of interest. How you can find? On 20 rupees for 1 year, I'm getting 1 rupee interest. I repeat, on 20 rupees, 1 rupee I'm getting interest. For 100 rupees, how much I'll get the interest? Because rate of interest must be for every 100 rupees. So simplification, 21 za, 25 za. How much I'm getting? Rate of interest is 5%. He asked to find out the rate of interest. So one question answer is, how much I'm getting? 5% I'm getting. And secondly, one more question, he asked to find the sum also. So we can use the formula, D is equal to PR square by 100 into 100. So difference I know, 40, 41. Difference how much? 1 rupee. So P value I need to find out now. R value just now I'm getting from previous concept, right? So from previous concept, R value, how much I'm getting here? Just now we have seen in previous session, R is equal to 5%. That's why. So here, R square means 5 into 5. 100 into 100. Simplification, 25 fours are 100. So finally, P is equal to what I am getting? 400 rupees. This is the case. So there are two different questions. One, he asked to find out rate of interest. Secondly, he asked to find out the, and sum is equal to I am getting 400. So this is regarding compound interest. And some questions we have seen, both compound interest and simple interest. Thank you.